Let me take you to the level number 3. This is most important. Somebody from your bank asked me the same question. Conquer and nurture the mind. You might feel that if anybody gives you a mic like this, you can stand and talk anything. बोलना बहुत आसान है, ये करके दिखाना बहुत मुश्किल है. यू आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई सेड डोंट ड्रॉप द माइंड. दैट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट. बुद्ध थ्रू आउट दिस जर्नी, इफ यू जस्ट स्टडी बुद्ध फ्रॉम डे नंबर 1 टिल द लास्ट डे, हिज मैसेज इज ओनली वन, ड्रॉप द माइंड. माइंड इज अ कल्प्रिट. माइंड यू टू ऑल द पॉसिबल नेगेटिव डायरेक्शंस बिकॉज इट वॉन्ट्स टेंशन. इट इज नॉट हैप्पी व्हेन यू आर पीसफुल. सो नाउ व्हेन यू आर सिटिंग इन दिस रूम, the mind is saying, just see whether something is biting you here, just confirm that everything is fine, and just reconfirm baju wala bhi sun raha hai kya. Mind is creating this. It will not allow you to remain there. The other day when I was doing a session for the senior management for a bank in Kolkata, they told, Matthew, you speak great about yoga, but can you do some asanas and help us do some exercise? I said, I will teach you everything in the world of yoga. Only one condition. Can you sit at one place for 15 minutes and show me? If you can do that, we will start. It is not possible. You have programmed yourself in this way that either here or here, aise hi haath aapka pocket mein jayega. Mobile hai ya nahi hai. Or another one more disease, a lot of people say, WhatsApp. It is just like, you know, the mother trying to check the baby's diapers. मैसेज आया नहीं आया, चेक करना जरूरी है क्या कुछ. इज एवरीथिंग ओके. डिजीज पीपल कैन नॉट सिट इन वन प्लेस, नॉट पॉसिबल. दैट इज व्हाई आई से कॉन्कर द माइंड. माइंड फर्स्ट ऑब्जर्व वेयर द माइंड इज टेकिंग यू, एंड लेट मी टेल यू, इट इज नीडेड, बट यू हैव टू जस्ट चेंज द डायरेक्शन. माइंड विल टेक यू टुवर्ड्स नथिंगनेस. देयर इज अ ब्यूटिफुल सेइंग इन हिंदी, ख्वाहिशों के काफिले भी बड़े अजीब से होते हैं, ये अक्सर गुजरते वहीं से हैं जहां पे रास्ते नहीं हुआ करते. गजब का हौसला दिया है खुदा ने हम इंसानों को, वाकिफ अगले पल की नहीं, वादे जिंदगी भर के किया करते हैं. दैट्स इट, दैट्स हाउ इट गोज. द माइंड विल टेक यू टू नथिंगनेस. इट विल कीप ऑन डाइवर्टिंग यू. द माइंड विल से, टुडे यू वॉन्ट अ 2 BHK फ्लैट. Very nice. But the day you get a 2 BHK flat, you think the mind will remain there? Just for few days. Till the time that puja and all is over. What is that? First day's puja. Vastu puja, yes. After that also you will celebrate. 15-20 days later on, the mind will say, 3 BHK is more important because, you know, now children are going a little big. Now they should need another room. You might, you are working in the banks, you might take some more loan here and there, you will buy a 3 BHK flat. Again you will do all those vastu, but you think your mind will be happy with the 3 BHK. No. Then you need a duplex. The mind will keep on taking you further and further and further, unless you say, from today onwards, you don't rule me, I will rule you. How to conquer the mind? How to conquer this mind? So difficult. And if you ask me, it's a new journey. But let me share one or two examples with you, one or two tricks with you. Observe life very carefully. You are nothing but a pattern. If somebody holds your hand, immediately a reaction happens. And that's a set pattern. Try to come up with new initiatives of the mind, new responses of the mind. You just see, for everything that is happening, the mind is sending the same patterns. Stop the mind there and say that, can I bring a newer response to this? When somebody says, you speak awesome, I feel happy, can I bring a newer response to this? Something better than that. Let me share a story with you. I'm sure you've all heard about the story in Ramayana. The story is long. Ram and Lakshman was into this jungle. For days together, they did not get anything to eat. They were very tired, just about to collapse. They were moving down south. They were on a journey. They wanted to wage a war against Ravan. And on the way, when they were just settled under a small tree, an old lady who was passing by, she sees these two guys. Does not seem to be from the jungle anymore. They look to be royal guys. But then yes, very tough people. Okay. So with lot of courage, they have their arms and ammunition and all with them. And still this lady piles courage, this old woman, and she comes close to Rama and says, "Who are you?" So Rama explains that we both are brothers and we are on a journey to fight a war against the man who has abducted my wife and all those things. So she says, "Seems like you all have not had anything for so many days. Would you like to have something to eat?" Ram says, "Yes, I would like to have something to eat." So she takes up this a wild berry from her small sack and she bites it and gives it to Ram. Ram has the first berry. Lakshman is observing this. What is this? He thought it was just by chance. She takes the next berry out, bites and gives it to him. Lakshman looks at Ram. Ram is enjoying the whole berry. Lakshman is not ready to accept this. Somehow he brings it to his mouth and he says, "Should I eat or not? Should I eat or not?" And he somehow eats. But the anger is coming up and up and up. He looks at Ram. Ram is enjoying. He takes the next one from her. When she's about to offer the second one, she bites and she throws this berry down. Takes one more from her bag, bites and gives this to Lakshman. Lakshman gets very angry. Lakshman says, "Ye kya kar raha?" Ram observes him very closely. So Ram slowly whispers, "Darshan karo. Darshan karo." Lakshman did not understand head and tail of the statement and he gets the berry. The third time when he gets the berry, Lakshman drops it. Ram says, "Darshan karo. Kuch nahi, darshan karo." Lakshman says, "What darshan karo? I don't understand what you are saying. Darshan karo. What is this mad lady doing from the beginning? Is this the way she is going to treat the royal kings, the prince? Does she know who we are? She is biting that berry and she is giving that with all the saliva and all on that. I cannot eat this anymore. You might be a god. I don't know. I cannot tolerate all this nonsense." Ram says, "Darshan karo. Krodh nahi, darshan karo." Then he drops his hand and says, "What do you mean by darshan karo? Explain me, brother, elder brother, explain me, darshan karo." Ram stands up and says, "You have been with me for so much time, you did not get the lessons of life. Observe this woman, I want to ask you a simple question. Did you see this particular person when she came to you? Does she know from what lineage you come? Who you are and what prince you are from? Which Ayodhya? Where is Ayodhya? Who knows? Does she know the rules and regulations of your palace? What is good and what is bad? What is mannerism and what is mannerism? Did you see that this old lady piled up so much of courage to come to these two young guys with arms and ammunition? Did you appreciate the fact that she is brought up so much of courage? And when she is offering this berry to you, instead of seeing the intention, you are reacting like an animal. What is the intention? What was she doing?" When she saw that two pious individuals are in front of that, she did not want to offer the bad, non-tasteful berries. So she was tasting the berry. And if it was really tasteful, she was offering this to you. And if it was not, she was not. She does not know your rules and regulations of the palace. Ye aapke community living or science mein sikhaya hoga. It does not. Darshan karo. Wo jo kar rahe. Go beyond the incidents. That what is the intention of the person? We are humans. We are bound to make mistakes. What is the intention? The other day when I was just in my office, we were supposed to submit a tender. And the time was 5 o'clock. There was a new office person who came and joined our office. And 5 o'clock he did not reach the ultimate place. And the people in the office were calling him frantically, kidhar hai, kidhar hai, kidhar hai. And 5:10 he reached there. Somehow what happened I don't know. And this person on the phone was just shouting, tum kis tarah se, tum kal se office mat aao, ye mat aao. I said, just hold on. Just hold on. I am not saying that you don't scold. But first, call up the authority and ask that 10 minutes we are late, can we submit to this? And just check what is the intention of that fellow. Was his intention that you should not submit the tender? Unka intention ye tha kya ki aapka business nahi aage bade aur aapko ye contract mile hi nahi, isiliye wo jaan bujh ke 5 se 5:15 tak niche baith ke upar. That is not the intention. Can you go beyond this reaction and check what really? He would have slipped from the train, we don't know. He would have got an injury on his leg, you don't know. He would have bandaged his leg and he would have reached there. You don't know, but you are reacting from your ordinary mind. Drop this mind, go beyond it. Zindagi mein har cheez ke darshan karo. Aur jis din aap ye karna seekhenge, you will have a new quality in your life. Remember this. What is the other way to manage the mind? Keep on giving good vitamins and proteins and carbohydrates to your mind as well. And what are these? Simple. Mind is searching. And mind maps here and there. I'm not talking about the Western philosophy of mind mapping. Mind keeps on mapping with stories, with experiences. In your culture, in this culture that I was born in, they knew the mind so beautifully. Want to train your mind, the game is very easy, simple. There are levels to the mind. If your mind is at the normal levels of existence, you don't know what is happening, unconscious life, just pick up the Puranas, all stories. Pick up any Upanishads, all stories. And these stories, you can relate it to your life and you can see whether I can live a life like this. Then the mind will say, bahut story sun liya maine. Kya hai ye story, story, story? Then you have something else, level number two. Pick up the Gita. Pick up the Mahabharata. 125,000 slokas. Pick up. Read everything from that. Pick up the story. What happened to Gandhari? What happened to Duryodhana? What happened to Arjuna? Why was Krishna there? What was he playing? Related to your life and me. These are all lessons for you and me to live a better life. Somebody is arguing. Some intellectual fellow is arguing whether the war of Mahabharata really happened or not. And they say that it is not all intelligence. We are operating from our normal level of intelligence. So there is some thesis happening and they are not there. So many people cannot fight the war. And during the war, you think that somebody can come in the center and talk all this. Both are ready to fight. It's a possibility. All said and done, fine. My argument is very simple. Assume that the war did not happen. With all your intelligence, ultimately, what are you going to prove? That the war did not happen. It did not happen. How does it matter to you? At least you have got a wonderful book called as Bhagavad Gita, which can change your and my life and has changed millions of life on this planet. The game is over. More simple. Stop this mind intelligence. Nahi hua hoga, wo nahi hua hoga, aisa kaisa hoga. Drop it. Take the best thought of it. And you'll realize that life is so beautiful. So after the Gita, still you are not happy, read the Ramayana. Experiences. Experiences of Maryada Purushottam Ram. How to live life in an ideal way. Still the mind says, no, go up. Then you have your Vedas. Abstract lines. They will not explain much. One line, the game is over. Samajhna hai to samjho, varna nahi. But you come down to such level of intelligence that once the Vedas get into your body, your mind, your soul, then a sudden realization happens of the Brahman. And that is why a Brahman is not born by birth. Krishna explains this many times. A Brahman is born by virtue. Even if you are born as a Shudra, not a problem. If you have come down to higher levels of consciousness and if you have understood the Veda, then you will understand that looks like I am a part of the whole Brahman. No difference. My body parts have just got extended in this auditorium and they are taking the best out of life. No difference. And the day you feel that you are one with the whole of the existence, you become a Brahman. So many a times I say, 715 people existing on this planet, everybody has an opportunity to become a Brahman. It is not anybody's right. You and I can become. Once you realize what the Vedas speak. But then it is a long journey to go to that level. But yes, you can tune your mind there. That's how we have been doing for so many years.